Welcome student. Actually we are studying paper 2 of mathematics and today's topic is application of derivative and we started first topic as geometrical meaning or geometrical application of derivative. Out of this we have completed our first type and now let me start our second type. Find the coordinates on a curve. And this is the application of derivative. So our first example is find the point on this curve where the tangent is perpendicular to the line 6x plus 3 bar minus 5 is equal to 0. सोल्यूशन स्टार्ट करण्यापूर्वी आपण ॲनालिसिस करूया की मला जर याचं सोल्यूशन काढायचं असेल तर मी कुठल्या कुठल्या स्टेप्स इथं ओबे करू शकते. सो लेट स्टार्ट ॲनालिसिस. इफ वी ड्रॉ या पर्टिक्युलर ग्राफची ही डायग्रॅम नाही पण साधारण कन्सेप्ट लक्षात यावा याच्यासाठी आपण डायग्रॅम ड्रॉ केलीची. डायग्रॅममध्ये काय काढलंय बघा. हा आहे कर्व वाय इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट एक्स मायनस 3. याचे टँजंट काढली आणि ह्या टँजंटला एक परपेंडिक्युलर लाईन काढली 6x प्लस 3y मायनस 5 इज इक्वल टू 0. तुम्हाला हा एक कर्व दिलाय आणि ही एक लाईन दिली. ह्या दोन लाईन दिलेल्या असताना ह्या कर्ववरचा कर्व अँड टँजंटवरचा इंटरसेक्टिंग पॉईंट तुम्हाला काढायचा आहे. आपण काय लॉजिक वापरणार. As we know, the slope of tangent is nothing but the first order derivative at this particular point. पण तुम्हाला पर्टिक्युलर पॉइंटच दिले नाही त्यामुळे हे डेरिव्हेटिव्ह तुम्हाला फंक्शनच्या फॉर्मॅटमध्ये मिळेल. त्याला इक्वेशन वन म्हणायचं. आणि ही जर लाईन ही लाईन तुमच्या टँजंटला परपेंडिक्युलर असेल तर ह्या लाईनचा स्लोप आणि टँजंटचा स्लोप हे एकमेकांचे निगेटिव्ह रेसिप्रोकल असते. म्हणजे टँजंटचा स्लोप तुम्हाला ह्या लाईनवरून मिळेल बरोबर आहे. तो नंबरमध्ये मिळेल. तो ती इक्वेशन आपण सेकंड घेऊया. स्लोप ऑफ टँजंट इक्वेशन वनवरून स्लोप ऑफ टँजंट ह्या लाईनवरून इक्वेट करायचे आपण आणि आपण फाइंड आउट करायचं आहे पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन. सो लेट कन्सिडर एक्स वन वाय वन इज अ पॉइंट लाय ऑन दिस कर्व. ॲज वी नो ॲज वी नो स्लोप ऑफ टँजंट इज नथिंग बट द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर डेरिव्हेटिव्ह विथ दिस पॉइंट. बट वी अजम स्लोप ऑफ टँजंट इज नथिंग बट एम वन. नाउ हाउ वी कॅन फाइंड स्लोप. इफ वाय इज दिस कर्व डिफरन्शिएटिंग दिस वी गेट डी वाय बाय डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू 1 upon 2 root x minus 3 and after replacing this first order derivative in this particular step we get equation 1. Equation 1 means slope of the tangent at this particular point. इथे आपण काय केलंय x ची व्हॅल्यू x1 पुट केली इथे y1 कुठेही नाही. नाउ as tangent is perpendicular to the line 6x plus 3y minus 5 is equal to 0. It implies what it implies? It implies slope of tangent is equal to negative reciprocal of slope of line which one 6x plus 3y minus 5. And if we find the slope of line 6x plus 3y minus 5 is equal to 0. As per our previous one knowledge, we can mention the slope of this line is nothing but minus a by b. So 6 is the value of A, 3 is the value of B, and C minus 5 is the value of C. If we compare this line in the form of AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. So corresponding values of A, B, C are 6, 3 and minus 5. And as per our previous one knowledge, the slope of this line is minus A by B. So minus 1 as it is, and minus A means minus 6 by 3. And after simplifying these identities, negative negative, it becomes positive. And 3 is simplified with 6, it gives half. So our slope of tangent is nothing but half. And this is the equation 2. Now from equation we get slope of tangent. Also from equation 2 we get slope of tangent. Now we compare these two identities and find the value of x1 and y1. So what we get? 1 upon 2 under root x1 minus 3 is equal to half from equation 1 and 2. Why we are comparing equation 1 and 2? Since the left hand side are same, we definitely say that, we can say that the right hand side also same. And that's why 1 upon 2 root x minus 1 divided by 2 root x1 minus 3 is equal to 1 divided by 2. So let me continue our point. Until we discuss that the slope of tangent, that means 1 upon 2 root x1 minus 3 is equal to half. Now we simplify this identity and find the corresponding values of x1, y1 which lie on this curve. So what we can simplify on the next line? I think we can cancel this 2 from left hand side and right hand side. And what we get after taking the reciprocal, we get that under root x1 minus 3 is equal to 1. And therefore we get this identity 2 root x1 minus 3 is equal to 1. Now to find the value of x1, we have to delete this under root sign, and definitely taking square root we can delete. Squaring on both sides, we can find the value of x1. Squaring both sides, we can cancel the value of under root. We can cancel the sign of under root and we get the plain value of x1. So what we can do? Squaring x1 minus 3 is equal to 1 x square. So what we get? X1 minus 3 is equal to 1, and it gives x1 is nothing but 3 plus 1 means 4. So this is the value of x1. Now we have to find the value of y. For that what we can do? Actually if you observe this diagram, this point lies on curve, not on the line. That's why we are putting the same value of x1 in curve, and we can find the value of y. So put x1 is equal to 4 in curve y is equal to under root x1 minus 3. It implies y1 is equal to under root x1 means minus x1 is 4, 4 minus 3 it is under root 1, and definitely we can say that y1 is nothing but plus or minus 1. So for value of x1 we get two different values of y1, so we get two different points on this curve. आणि मी ऑलरेडी म्हटलेलो ही डायग्राम हा पर्टिक्युलर कर्वची नाही, आपण फक्त बेसिक कन्सेप्ट समजून घेण्याकरता ती लाईन काढलेली आहे. सो रिक्वायर्ड पॉइंट्स आर, वी हॅव टू डिफरंट पॉइंट्स बट द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ एक्स वन सेम, बट वी कॅन डिफरेंशिएट और वी कॅन मेन्शन द सेकंड व्हॅल्यू ऑफ वाय ॲज मायनस वन अँड फर्स्ट व्हॅल्यू ऑफ वाय ॲज प्लस वन. सो रिक्वायर्ड पॉइंट्स आर, so required points on curve are first point x1 y1, x1 is 4 and we take first value of y1 as a plus 1 and second value is x1 is as it is 4 but y1 with negative minus 1. So required points on curve are 4, 1, 4, minus 1. And let me stop here. Good morning guys. Now we start our third time of the topic application of derivative. This type is based on find the equation of tangent or normal when tangent is parallel to given line or tangent is parallel to perpendicular to given line. Maybe some of the times normal is perpendicular to given line and normal is parallel to given line. Ashna sudha possibilities as well. So we start with our first example. Find the equation of normal to the curve 3x square minus y square is equal to 8, which are parallel to the line x plus 3 bar is equal to 4. So before starting the solution, let the analysis what we have to do. जर मी ह्या डायग्रामची एक जनरल डायग्राम ड्रॉ केली की हे जे काय आयडेंटिटीज दिलेली आहेत, तुम्हाला एक कर्व दिला आहे बरोबर, आपण काय केलं आहे ह्या कर्व काढलेला आहे एक्स आणि वाय ॲक्सिसमध्ये. ह्या कर्वचं इक्वेशन आहे 3x स्क्वेअर मायनस वाय स्क्वेअर इज इक्वल टू 8, हा कर्व आहे. ही डायग्रॅम पुन्हा एकदा बांधतो, आपण जनरल डायग्रॅम काढतो आहे, ह्या कुठल्याही पर्टिक्युलर कर्वची नाही आहे. पण आपण जनरल डायग्रॅम का काढतो आहे की तिथं काय काय दिलं आहे, मी काय काय फाइंड आउट करू शकते आणि मी कुठल्या मेथडनी ते वापरू शकते, कुठं कुठल्या आयडेंटिटीज, फक्त याच्यासाठी ही डायग्रॅम असेल. मग हा कर्व दिला आहे बरोबर, ह्या कर्व बरोबर ह्या कर्वच्या नॉर्मलला परपेंडिक्युलर नाही, पॅरलल लाईन दिली, ठीक आहे. मग जर मी हा कर्व काढला तर ह्या कर्वला इथं मी कुठंतरी टँजेंट काढणार, येते का लक्षात, ही आहे टँजेंट, ठीक आहे. पण टँजेंट आपल्याला लागत नाही ही टँजेंट, कारण की तुम्हाला इक्वेशन नॉर्मलचं काढायचं आहे. ही आहे टँजेंट, त्याला ही नॉर्मल काढली आणि ह्या नॉर्मलचं इक्वेशन तुम्हाला फाइंड आउट करायचं आहे, लक्षात येत आहे. मग दिलंय काय, ह्या नॉर्मलला अजून एक पॅरलल लाईन दिली की तुम्ही इकडे काढू शकता, अदरवाईज या साईडला काढू शकता. मला जागा या साईडला आहे म्हणून मी या साईडला काढली बरोबर. म्हणजे तुम्हाला एक कर्व दिलेला आहे, तुम्हाला कर्वच्या नॉर्मलला पॅरलल लाईन एक आहे त्याचं इक्वेशन दिले एक्स प्लस थ्री बाय इज इक्वल टू 4. काय करू शकतो आपण व्यवस्थित ऑब्झर्व करा, नॉर्मलचंच इक्वेशन काढायचं आहे आणि नॉर्मललाच पॅरलल लाईन दिली तर आपण काय काढू शकतो. जर नॉर्मल दुसऱ्या एका लाईनला पॅरलल असेल तर डेफिनेटली ह्या दोन्हीही लाईनचा स्लोप सेम असणारे, हा एक कन्सेप्ट आपण वापरायचा आहे बरोबर आहे. हा कन्सेप्ट तुम्हाला वापरताना ह्या लाईनच्या इक्वेशनवरून नंबरच्या फॉर्मॅटमध्ये नॉर्मलचा स्लोप मिळेल. पण जर तुम्हाला नॉर्मल से इक्वेशन काढायचं असेल तर आपण टेंजेंट आणि नॉर्मल च्या इक्वेशन साठी पॉइंट्स लॉ फॉर्म्युला काढतो. याचा अर्थ आपल्याला पॉइंट पण काढायला लागेल. नॉर्मलचा स्लोप तर आपण काढलेलाच आहे ह्या दिलेल्या लाईनवरून. प्रश्न राहतोय की हा पॉइंट तुम्ही कसा काढणार. मग त्या पॉइंटसाठी आपण काय करूया, तर प्रिवियस वन आर्टिकल जे आहे, प्रिवियस वन माझी जी एक्झाम्पल मी घेतलेलं त्यात आपण काय केलेलं, ॲप्लिकेशन वापरतोय. दिलेल्या कर्वचं फर्स्ट ऑर्डर डेरिव्हेटिव्ह घ्यायचं, म्हणजे याचं त्याच्यामध्ये आपण अझम केलेला पॉइंट घ्यायचा आणि ते फर्स्ट ऑर्डर डेरिव्हेटिव्ह इज नथिंग बट द स्लोप ऑफ द टँजेंट. त्या स्लोपवरून मी नॉर्मलचा स्लोप काढेन कसा, बाय टेकिंग द रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ दॅट स्लोप. ती इक्वेशन मिळेल मिळेल ह्या लाईनवरून नॉर्मलचा स्लोप मिळेल नंबरमध्ये, ती इक्वेशन सेकंड मिळेल. दोन्ही इक्वेशन कंबाईन करायच्या जसं मी प्रिवियस वन एक्झाम्पलमध्ये केलेलं तसं, आणि एक्स वन वाय वन काढायचा. काय काय काढणार आपण पहा, मी ॲनालिसिस करते. टू फाइंड द इक्वेशन ऑफ दिस नॉर्मल आपण वापरतोय पॉइंट स्लोप फॉर्म्युला, म्हणजे मला पॉइंट काढायचा आहे ह्या नॉर्मलचा स्लोप काढायचा आहे. स्लोप याच्यावरून काढणार आणि पॉइंट आपण टँजेंटच्या इक्वेशनवरून नॉर्मलचा इक्वेशन फाइंड आउट करायचं, दिलेल्या लाईनचा नॉर्मलचा स्लोप आणि काढलेला आपण नंबर्समधला एक्स आणि वायमधला तो इक्वेट करायचा आणि एक्स वन वाय वनच्या व्हॅल्यू काढायचे. दिस इज द ॲनालिसिस विच आयडेंटिटीज वी हॅव युझिंग हियर. नाऊ लेट मी स्टार्ट. वी स्टार्ट विथ दॅट लेट पॉइंट एक्स वन वाय वन लाईज ऑन दिस कर्व 3x² - y² = 8. सो आवर फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज फर्स्ट ऑर्डर डेरिव्हेटिव्ह ऑफ दिस गिवन पॉइंट इज नथिंग बट द स्लोप ऑफ टँजेंट. सो वी गेट दॅट ॲज स्लोप ऑफ टँजेंट इज इक्वल टू, and for that we have to differentiate this. Slope of tangent is nothing but dy by dx at our point x1 y1. But how we can find the first order derivative? As we have 3x² - y² = 8, which is implicit function which lies in to both variables x and y. That's why differentiating this we get the value of dy by dx. So differentiating this we get the value of dy by dx. So firstly we differentiate 3x square. 3 as it is, derivative of x square should be 2x, so 3 into 2 it becomes 6x, minus derivative of y square should be 2y, dy by dx, and derivative of 8 is 0. Now if we shift dy by dx to the right hand side, we get that dy by dx is equal to, if we shift this identity to the right hand side, 6x divided by 2y remains as it is. 6x divided by 2y, 6x divided by 2y, and after simplifying this we get 3x divided by y as the value of derivative. Now we replace this value in this particular identity. What we get? We get that dy by dx is nothing but 3x plus y, but we have to replace the corresponding value of x1 y1. So slope of the tangent is nothing but 3x1 divided by y. ही आपल्याला स्लोप ऑफ टँजेंटची व्हॅल्यू मिळाली आणि याला आपण म्हणूया इक्वेशन 1. हे झालं इक्वेशन 1. नाव व्हॉट टू डू नाव, ॲज दिस नॉर्मल इज परपेंडिक्युलर टू लाईन Now, if this is the slope of tangent, after taking negative reciprocal of this tangent, we can find the slope of normal. Therefore, slope of normal is equal to negative reciprocal of slope of tangent. Now if we replace the corresponding value, it is minus 1 upon which one? 3x1 divided by y1. And after taking reciprocal, what we get? We get that minus y1 divided by 3x1 as the slope of the normal. As the slope of the normal, if we require this identity, we mention this identity as equation 2nd, 3rd and 4th. Now what we get? We get slope of normal from our theory, and as normal is parallel to our line, which one line? This one, x plus 3y is equal to 4, and therefore slope of normal is equal to slope of line x plus 3y is equal to 4. Since these two lines, this normal and given line, are same, their slope are also equal. So their slope are also equal. Therefore, slope of normal is equal to slope of this line. Now what is the slope of this line? Now as per our previous knowledge, if we compare this line to ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, the value of a is nothing but 1, the value of b is nothing but 3, and the value of c is nothing but the minus 4 after shifting 4 to the left hand side. So what is the slope of this line? I think slope of this line is nothing but minus a by b. So its slope should be minus 1 upon 3. Minus a means minus 1 divided by b, 3. So slope of normal is minus 1 by 3. So we mention this identity as we require. Here slope of normal is equation 2nd and slope of normal as equation 3rd. Now if we observe the left hand side of equation 2nd and left hand side of equation 3rd, both are same, and that's why we can say that their right hand side are also same from equation 2nd and 3rd. So from equation 2nd and 3rd, what we can write? We can say that minus y1 divided by 3x1 is equal to minus 1 upon 3. Now if we simplify, what we get? We get that negative it becomes positive, since cancelling this negative sign. Similarly, we can cancel this 3, and definitely we can say that x1 is nothing but the y1. Actually, we are finding point. Simultaneously, we are finding the slope of the normal. So, slope of the normal is minus 1 by 3. So, remaining is that anyhow find the value of x1 and y1. But we find the value of x1 and y1 in terms of each other. We have to find these two values in the form of numbers. So what we can do? Since this point which we have assumed here in diagram, it lies in curve, So after putting the value of x1, y1 in this curve, we can find the particular values of x and y1. Okay, so let me start. Now we are putting this point in this curve as point x1, y1 lies on curve. Which one? 3x square minus y square is equal to 8. Now we put y1 as x1 in this equation and find the value of x1. So it implies 3x1 square. We put the value of x as x1 and value of y1 as again x1. So it may be written as minus x1 square is equal to 8. Now what is the next line? It totally lies in one variable. So 3x1 square minus x1 square, it gives 2x1 square is equal to 8. And it implies x1 square is nothing but 4 after dividing 2. And definitely we get x1 is nothing but plus or minus 2 after taking under root. So we get the value of x1 is nothing but plus or minus 1. But our previous one simplification implies that both are same. So we get two different points at the value of x1. So I will mention here. So points on curve are x1, y1 is equal to. So first x1 is 2 and x1 is similar as to 2, y1. So we get first point as 2 with 2 and second point with minus 2 with minus 2. If you like the record, karte baha. आपण x1 आणि y1 चे व्हॅल्यू इथं सिम्प्लिफिकेशन म्हणून सेम आहेत ह्या दाखवल्यात. आणि जर मुळात x1 ची व्हॅल्यू एकदा 2 असेल आणि एकदा मायनस 2 असेल तर y1 ची व्हॅल्यू सुद्धा एकदा प्लस 2 आणि मायनस 2 असेल. म्हणून तुमचे पॉईंट झाले की x1 ची व्हॅल्यू 2, y1 ची व्हॅल्यू 2, x1 ची व्हॅल्यू मायनस 2, y1 ची व्हॅल्यू मायनस 2. अँड सो दीज आर द रिक्वायर्ड पॉईंट्स. अँड वी हॅव the slope of normal is minus 1 by 3 and points are 2, 2, minus 2, minus 2. Now using these corresponding two points and slope of the normal, we can find the equation of normal. So student, we will continue our point. Actually we are starting the solution of this point and we have to find the equation of normal to the curve which are parallel to this given line. And up till we find the corresponding point on curves, points on curves are 2, 2 and minus 2, minus 2 with a slope and slope of normal m is equal to, I think, minus 1 upon 2. So by using point slope formula, we can find the equation of normal. So let me take first point as 2, 2 on the curve, which is also lies on this normal also. So we take first point as 2, 2 and slope of the normal as minus 1 by 2. So what is our next line? Equation of normal at the point x1, y1. And x1, y1 is nothing but 2, 2 with slope m is equal to minus 1 by 3 is 1 minus y is equal to m into x minus x1 by using Poisson's formula. So we put the corresponding values in this particular identity. What we get? Y as it is minus y1 is nothing but 2 is equal to n is nothing but minus 1 by 3 into x minus x1. So x as it is and value of x1 is 2. So how we simplify? Now we multiply this 3. The left hand side we get that 3y minus 6 is equal to. If we multiply minus 1 to the inner identities, it gives minus x and minus minus plus 2. So what we get? Now, as per our discussion, we have to find the equation of normal or equation of tangent such that the coefficient of x should be positive and all terms, we have to shift all terms to the left hand side and to the right hand side, we have a zero. So we simplify this identity such that the coefficient of x is positive and to the right hand side there is zero. So to get such a solution, we have to shift all the right hand side identities to the left hand side. And we are addressing, we are simplifying this equation in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That means sequence is in the form of x, then y and then constant. So we shifted this to the left hand side, gives x, after shifting a negative x to the left hand side, it becomes positive. And after shifting plus 2 to the left hand side, it becomes negative. So positive x plus 3y from the left hand side and shifting minus 2 to the left hand side, it gives minus 8 is equal to 0. So this is the first equation of normal at this point and in this slope. Now we find, what we find? Now we find second equation of normal. So equation of normal at a point, which one? X1, Y1. But point is next one, this one, minus 2 to 2, with this slope, with this slope, n is equal to minus 1 by 3, and is by slope point form, y is equal to y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Now we put the corresponding values in slope point form as y minus, I think y1 is also negative, this point should be minus 2 to minus 2. So y minus minus 2, so minus 2 is equal to m is nothing but minus 1 upon 3 into in bracket x minus x1 means minus 2. So I think this minus minus becomes plus and this minus minus becomes plus. So we can write y plus 2 is equal to minus 1 upon 3 into in bracket x plus 2. Now what is the like next simplification? Now multiply 3 to the left hand side. Simultaneously, we are applying negative sign to the inner quantities. So it is 3y plus 6 is equal to minus x and minus 2. Now, as per our discussion, we have to write the equation of normal and tangent in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That means coefficient of x should be positive and all terms are shifted to the left hand side and to the right hand side there is 0. That's why we are shifting this, these terms to the left hand side. What we get? X plus 3y and after shifting these two we get 6 plus 2a is equal to 0. So we get two different equations of normal at our two different points. So our first equation is x plus 3y minus a is equal to 0. and next is x plus 3y plus 8 is equal to 0. And by using slope point formula, we can solve this example and find the corresponding equation of normal. And hence we stop here.